What's going on, everybody? Welcome back to another video. Today we're going to check out update 2019.16.3.2. Not all that exciting of an update. It's just a bug fix update. If you're enjoying my videos, hit like, get subscribed. Let's check it out. So not all that exciting of an update. In 2019.16.2, which is the update right before this one, people were having some problems with autopilot not working anymore. So they updated, and then they get in their car and go to drive, and they couldn't turn on autopilot. On the display here, there were no lanes, no other cars were being shown. They actually couldn't even use their cruise control. And I did experience that for just a minute when I first got that update. I'll show you a clip of that. All right, so I just got this message. Navigate on autopilot currently unavailable. And I thought it was because the rain just started picking up, but it says features may be available on next drive. So that's not an issue with the weather. So I figure I would just put this out there and let everybody know that people are seeming to have a better time with this update now. They're not getting that same error. I really didn't have any issues in 2019.16.2. My autopilot always worked great besides those few minutes after the initial update. But I thought we could just do some testing here. Just do a few miles, make sure everything is functioning appropriately. So like all my videos, there will be timestamps in the description, so you can look down there. Any interesting things that happened during the drive, I'll put a timestamp there. I'm using Navigate on Autopilot, so the car is controlling my speed, steering, and it will change lanes to go around cars that are slow, or it'll change lanes to take exits, it'll take exits for me, things like that. So I usually attempt to let the car do as much as it can. I try not to interfere, especially for the videos. You know, when I'm making the videos, I really make it a point to just let the car do its thing. So I have noticed on this update, the following distance seems to have increased. So right now I'm at a one, I was at a two following distance. I normally keep it, all right, so we're gonna change. Okay, car did all that. I normally keep my following distance at a 3, at least before this latest update, and now I'm keeping it usually at a 2 or even a 1, because the car just, for whatever reason, wants to be so far away. And, you know, of course that's safe and everything, but then people around you kind of get annoyed and they cut you off and things like that, which is then annoying to me. I also probably won't use this camera the whole time. Honestly, it's kind of annoying to sync up the footage, but I figure for intros and things like that, it would be nice. I did get a request to use this. People were telling me they wanted to see me as I was talking. So I don't have a problem with that. You know, anything that you want from the videos, maybe you think I'm doing wrong or you'd like improved or any suggestions, I'm open to all that. I do respond to all the comments. YouTube has not been giving me notifications lately for a lot of them though. So if I'm not responding, I don't know, comment again or something, and I will get back to you if I see your comment. I will respond. All right, so we're changing again. There's a car in our way here. My car's slowing down a bit and getting over. Yeah, this is all working really well. I've had a really good time with my Navigate on Autopilot, making lane changes and stuff. All right, so the car wants to change lanes. It's a little busy over there. Nobody's gonna let me in. Nope. It was gonna, but the guy didn't want to slow down for me, so it abandoned. And now we'll change lanes. That's pretty interesting. So in those situations, I don't normally just leave it like that, leave the blinker on. But I wanted to see what would happen. And pretty much what, you know, happens when you're driving, you turn your blinker on and nobody wants to let you in. Except the car keeps trying. I've never seen it bail like that, so that was pretty interesting. It started to do it, and then it determined, eh, that car's coming a little too fast, I'll just stay where I am. Alright, so coming up at a part where autopilot normally has a little bit of issues, I should say Navigate on Autopilot, for whatever reason, the system thinks I need to be in the right lane, and it doesn't matter, I can be in either lane and get to where I'm going. And it always, so there it is, upcoming lane change. It's just unnecessary. I don't need to make this lane change. And you have a lot of traffic coming in from the right, and then you kind of get in their way. So we'll see what the car does here. If this new update has changed its behavior, maybe made it a little better. No. All right, I'm going to hit the accelerator and get out of that guy's way. Okay, so it did make the lane change. I'm not sure what he's doing. He's got his turn signal on, but he's not changing lanes. Okay, there he goes. Here, I should put this on for you. He had his turn signal on forever, and he wasn't changing lanes, so I thought maybe he didn't know it was on. So this area just has a little mistake with the maps, or I don't know how it determines we have to be in this lane. I have no idea why it thinks that, but like I said, it's just completely wrong. I can be, the left lane is actually where I would prefer to be, and so normally when I'm driving, if I'm not recording a video, I stay in the left lane myself. Here, I'll get over, and then you'll see the car will move back over after this. But I will get in this lane by myself, so you can see behind the camera. It wants to change back, so I'll let it for the video. But I'll get in that lane myself, and I'll turn Navigate on Autopilot off so that it won't want to change back. So then this is where it's annoying. Oh, okay. So that is improved. So it didn't used to allow me to, I should say, it didn't used to want to use this lane until after people were done getting on from over here. And it's really annoying, right? Because then you're kind of in their way. But okay, so that's a slight improvement. I would not say that's fixed by any means. It's still annoying. I'd rather just stay where I was. But it does seem better than it used to be. All right, we've got another slowdown here. Our exit is coming up. You can see, I put this camera up. I feel like it helps you kind of see more of what's going on. But the car is going to want to change lanes here soon. Our exit is in 0.8 miles. So we'll see how it handles that. Okay, the car is deciding it's time. Let's see if someone will let us over. Not this red car. That's no big deal. I'm not surprised by that. But hopefully the next person. No, they just want to be in our way. Oh, just ignore my turn signal. Okay. That's fine. Maybe the next guy. Thank you so much. I'll give them a wave. So that's, in my opinion, one of the biggest problems with the cars that are going to be self-driving is they're going to be a little too polite. You know, you can see we had three cars in a row that wouldn't let us in. The first one made perfect sense. They were pretty close to us when I turned my turn signal on. They just continued on. The next car probably should have let us in. but, I mean, whatever. What are you going to do? If the car is going to be too polite, people are just going to pass you. A lot of people will be a lot more aggressive when they're changing lanes, right? They'll kind of start sticking their nose over and all that. But for now, that's what we have to deal with. The polite car with not-so-polite people leads to waiting for a while to change lanes. Okay, here's our exit coming up on the right. Nice, calm exit by autopilot. I'll see if we can get a right turn out of autopilot up here. It's worked here once or twice. Let's see if it can do it today. Getting a little confused there. We got no one to... Oh, there's one guy here. Okay. So if he'll stop us... Nope. So I may have to stop. Well, that's clear. Got no cars. Oh, perfect. Look at that. A really good right turn. We did go through the red light, but there was no cars coming. I looked before. I was able to stop if I needed to. Another issue people were having was with the emergency lane departure warnings. So actually, when Stephanie did her video, she got one of those warnings on the dirt road, which is hilarious because it's supposed to be responding to, you know, the lane lines.
What? Corrective steering applied for your safety. Potential collision detected.
So I can give that a few tests here with no other cars in the other lanes. So a good fix there. I'll give it another try. Yep, so just bouncing me back into the lane. And even, wow, I think it even straightened the wheel. That was cool. So yeah, it's keeping me in the lane. I haven't had any issues with it. I've heard people complain about they intentionally try to avoid something. So let's say I showed this in the other update video I made, but there's a person on the side of the road and you kind of, well, there's a car in my way, but I'll do it. There's a person on the side of the road you're trying to avoid, so you kind of get out of the way. So if we just do that, so I didn't get anything. It didn't respond. So it's weird, the complaints. I mean, it's not like I don't believe them. I'm sure they're having these issues, but every time I intentionally try to steer over the line, the car doesn't seem to have a problem with that. It's only when I'm drifting over. So again, pretend there's somebody here, I gotta avoid them, and nothing. The car didn't respond at all. It didn't do anything. Now if I drift over here, I'm not steering, it bounces, it works every time. It bounces me back into the lane. So, I don't know. I haven't had that issue one time. I haven't had any problems with it. So maybe there's some sensors need some calibrating or, you know, something. Who knows? But hopefully people don't keep having that issue. So 2019.16.3.2, nothing all too exciting, just bug fixes. But it is nice that, you know, Tesla kind of heard the complaints and got that update out really quick. I think it was about a week from the last update. And normally software updates take anywhere from 2 to 3 weeks. So again, not that exciting, but it is always fun to test out autopilot. It seems to be doing really well in the current version. Sometimes you'll get, you know, revisions where it kind of does worse than it used to do. I haven't really experienced that, but I've just heard some stories. If you have any questions, leave them below. That's all for this one. I'll see you next time.